I'm sure this movie's just gonna have a really happy ending and I'm just gonna feel great.
Just gonna go ahead and get these ready.
Supernova is brought to us by director Harry McQueen and stars Colin Firth and Stanley Tucci. We follow Sam and Tusker, played by Firth and Tucci. A married couple, well, I'm not really sure if they're married. It never really says for sure if they're married, but they're definitely a couple, that's for sure. They're taking a trip across England in their RV to go to an event, and along the way, they're going to visit some friends and family. However, it's not quite that simple because, you know, it never is. Tusker was diagnosed with dementia 2 years ago, and the couple have been living with it ever since. However, recently things have started to deteriorate a bit faster. He's not like totally gone yet, but things are starting to get a bit more difficult for both of them. So you get the feeling that they see this trip as kind of a last hurrah in the way that they've always been. So we get to see their trip and relationship play out as they try and figure out how they are going to deal with this situation moving forward. Supernova is a movie that I became aware of around the beginning of last year, and it was set to release around like September, October of 2020. Unfortunately, like so many other movies, it got delayed, but I didn't know to when, and as it so happens, it got released about a month ago and I didn't even know it. So I finally got the opportunity to catch it, and holy shit, if you've ever wanted to know what Oscar-winning performances look like, watch this fucking movie. This movie has a lot of good things going for it, but the number one thing above everything else is it's absolutely beautiful, amazing, gut-wrenching at times, so real it hurts performances. Colin Firth and Stanley Tucci, but especially Colin Firth, fucking kill it here, man. From the little bickering moments that this couple has throughout their adventure that I think pretty much anybody who's been in a relationship before of any amount of time can totally relate with, all the way to the hard discussions and the way that we react to them at times, regardless if it makes sense or not what we're saying and how we react to some of these things, it is how we react, and that is how it plays out here. These characters are written wonderfully and performed beautifully here. This is not a fast-paced story. There's not even a whole lot that really happens in it. It is more or less just this couple going across country, stopping off at a few places, and getting to an inevitable end. But it's what happens in between, the discoveries and the discussions, and just this life, this relationship with this really bad thing that's going on, that's looming over it all, and how they handle that. That is what's so great about this movie. It never, ever, not one single time feels false. Never does it seem like this is not real. This all just seems like real life. Like this is how people would deal with this situation. Now, when I said that not a whole lot happens, that doesn't mean nothing happens. There are things that pop up. There are situations and hurdles that come up with them, and they do have to deal with them. And man, some of it is just fucking gut-wrenching. Some of it's like big things that actually come up, especially closer to the end of the movie, but there are moments when just the whole situation weighs down on them and they have to deal with it, and that stuff is just, wow, it's exhausting. It's just so tough to watch at times. But tough or not, I could not pull myself away from it. I was enthralled with this movie from beginning to end. It's crazy that a movie that doesn't really have a lot of events of note that happen in it is so enthralling. Never have I watched just two people on screen go through life and just deal with shit and been so interested. And while there's plenty of praise that should be given to McQueen, the director, a lot of that is absolutely on the shoulders of Colin Firth and Stanley Tucci. This movie asks some tough questions, and they're not even questions that you have answers to. It's just the question itself that's difficult, and the fact that people have to deal with that. The fact that people have to face these types of questions and actually come up with answers to them that's so difficult. There is, of course, a thing that happens eventually that we do have to face in the movie. And that was just, man, I just don't know how you would deal with that. I don't know how I would deal with it. I know how the characters in the movie deal with it, but being faced with something like that is almost impossible to imagine. And Firth and Tucci do a fantastic job of conveying that to us in a realistic, believable, heartbreaking way. Now that's not to say that the entire movie is just tears and heartbreak and crying and sorrow. No, there's a lot of happy moments in this movie as well. In fact, the movie as a whole is kind of happy if you look at it from the right perspective. Yes, they're going through this awful thing, this thing that, man, just nobody should ever have to go through, but unfortunately people do. But the fact that they have each other to go through this thing together with, and the fact that they don't leave, they don't ditch out on each other, is something beautiful unto itself. The fact that there's a strong enough love between these two people that keeps them together in one of the most difficult of times is a very happy thing if you look at it from that angle. And as one of the characters so wisely says, the only reason people mourn something is because it was so great when it was here. Now, there is something else I really want to commend the film for, and that is the way that it ended. It did not end the way that I expected it to end, and I don't think it's going to end the way anyone really expects it to. When it comes to films like this, we typically expect how they're going to end. We know how these kind of movies go. But this movie goes about it a different way. They didn't take the cheap route. They don't go for the low blow. They're not trying to like squeeze all the tears out of you that they can. Now, that's not to say that there aren't some moments in this movie, including moments closer to the end, that are definitely there to suck up some tears from you. But the fact of the matter is that's not all it is. It didn't seem cheap. It all seemed very earned when it happened. And the way that they went about the ending was very refreshing. It wasn't what I expected. I expected something wholly different than what we got, and I really commend them for going that route. Overall, this was just an amazingly beautiful story about two people trying to make it in the world that absolutely adore each other, and the difficult hurdles that they have to face that can't always be defeated, but they will do it together. It was a beautiful story, and it was executed wonderfully. Now, from a performance standpoint, it should come as no surprise at this point that this was some good shit all around. Colin Firth and Stanley Tucci, fucking amazing all around. No flaws whatsoever in these performances. These are amazing Academy Award winning level performances. Colin Firth especially. Nothing against Tucci, but Colin Firth especially. We kind of see the world through his eyes a little bit more than Tucci's. And holy shit, this guy, if he doesn't get nominated at least at this year's Academy Awards, there's just something wrong in the world. But we've known something's been wrong in the world with those awards for quite some time. But whatever, I digress. Needless to say, these are some fantastic performances, but they're not the only ones. Everybody here does a fantastic job. There's not a ton of people in the movie. Mostly it's just these two, but the other people that we do get, they're wonderful as well. This is some of the best overall acting I've seen in a film definitely all year, if not much longer than that. This is a fantastically acted film. The film also looks really good. It has some beautiful cinematography as they drive across England, and we get some real beautiful shots of like the countryside. This isn't like a special effects showcase or anything. As far as I can tell, it's just all cinematography, but the cinematography here is really good. It doesn't go out of its way to have like crazy camera angles or like movements or anything like that. It's not doing anything to detract from what's going on screen and the wonderful performances there. But what is here looks really good, especially the outdoor shots while they're driving around. Some of that is some really, really pretty countryside. Guys, I really can't say much more about Supernova without ruining something, and I really don't want to do that. I want everyone to go into this movie as blind as possible and just experience this wonderful little tale. And that's what it is, just a story about two people out in the world like anyone else having to deal with an impossible situation. The story will keep you involved from its humorous beginning all the way to its unconventional ending. The performances are some of the best damn performances around, and will keep you glued to that screen and totally invested in these characters all the way to the end, and you'll just want more after that. You may not be emotionally prepared for it, but you will want more from these characters. And while this may be a movie you're only really gonna want to watch once, that one time is absolutely worth a rent.
All he wanted was
to return some videotape.
This is an absolutely beautiful movie. However, it is a tough watch, so just be prepared for that when you watch it. But if you're up for a tough watch and just an absolutely wonderfully acted, beautiful film, then check out Supernova one night, and I think you're gonna have a wonderful time with it. Get these fuckers ready, though. So there it is, guys, my review of Supernova. If you enjoyed and want more content like this, hit that subscribe button and help my little channel grow. If you liked what I had to say, give me a like. If not, let me know in the comments below why. And as always, stay sexy, Cardiff.
If you had one wish in the world, what would it be?
I wish this holiday wouldn't end.
There's quite a few great moments in this movie, but there was one in particular that really stood out to me, and it is a pretty small moment. I won't spoil it, but there is a part where Stanley Tucci is talking to his brother-in-law outside at a party. The two are just having some innocent banter back and forth, ha-haing it up, and then just something really serious is thrown out. And it was just like the realism of it all, and the great performances, and the reaction that it got, just the subtle little reaction was just like, fuck. I mean, I was sitting there, I'm not a big crier, but I was just sitting there watching it, just thinking, yeah, I don't feel like this moment should be eliciting this type of reaction from me, but I'm just watching this.
Just a man watching this movie.
I mean, holy shit, this was a really simple moment, and it just really hit hard. Like, I'm sitting there, and this fucking scene comes out of nowhere, and I don't even know if it was intending on it, but just everything about it just... just reaches in and Kano rips your fucking heart out. I mean, damn, that's only halfway through the movie. What the fuck else is coming?
Kano wins, you fucking beauty.